Hello, it's Polish Paul VR. Welcome to the channel, and let's do freshest PSVR news in the village. As always, I'm hoping you all doing well, keeping safe, and of course playing some awesome PlayStation VR games. Just a reminder, you can still enter Golem giveaway. Go to the latest episode of PSVR Super Show, and that's gonna tell you how to enter it. The results will be at some point this week. My schedule is a bit all over the place, so I'm struggling to do the live stream. But for sure, I'm gonna find time at some point before the end of the week. And of course, good luck, this is the giveaway for the EU version of the game. Also, let me remind you, official channel merch is here. If you like it, go and check it out. If you like something, buy it. If you're on Twitter, do a photo, tag me in so I can have a look. And of course, I can retweet Only Gamer in the Village merch. It's perfectly suited for this channel. But anyway, let's get into the news. And today we're gonna start from Saints and Sinners. As you know, yesterday the Walking Dead Saints and Sinners Meat Grinder update has come out and it's amazing. People already saying how difficult it is, how crazy it is, and how good of an exercise it is. The update is amazing. It's added this trial mode, which lets you fight 20 waves of the walkers attacking you. But also apart from that, it's adding the story mode difficulty when they letting you get away with the stamina and health. But also there is more resources, and all in all, it's designed for people who just want to experience the story without faffing around with all the survival stuff around it. And of course, also it's added voice immersion, something what many PlayStation VR owners requested, because now the zombies can hear you, so you have to stay quiet. But anyway, that's not everything I want to talk about, because what the developer did with their press release, they've done little questions and answer session, and one of the questions is about future DLCs, and basically they teasing something, they saying stay tuned. So it looks like they not done yet. Something else will be coming to Saints and Sinners. What it is, of course, we do not know yet, but what we know is to stay tuned, because they probably eventually gonna be announcing some more DLC. And this DLC, of course, will be for PSVR and PCVR version. So I'm excited to see what it is, but nevertheless, with this update, the already big game got even bigger. So with next DLC, it's gonna be even more massive. What a success story for Skydance Interactive. The Meat Grinder update is tons of fun. Of course, it's totally free. All you have to do to update your game and then just download 8.9 gigabytes of update. And as always, stay tuned to the channel, because as soon as I know anything about the future DLC, I will be passing it on straight away to you, as always. Anyway, let's move on to the next game. And we're gonna talk about Zero Calibre, a game that many people want, but sadly a game that got very big delay, because we know it's gonna come in Q4 this year, and my best guess is gonna be more towards the end of the year. What's happened in past, they wanted to release it in Q2, of course pandemic happened and they got slowed down a lot, but also apart from that, they've had some issues with optimizations, so they cannot achieve the frame rate. Of course they're gonna do it, it's just taking a bit longer. But also what we know, there will be no aim controller support, as they tested it and they figured out that this is just not working because of how much your hands are involved in the game. So you know, your manual reloading, you can change attachments of the fly, climbing and stuff like that. So even though Zero Calibre is delayed, it's still gonna happen and probably gonna be great. But what people was interested in, how they gonna go about the locomotion options, how will it work. So the game will only use move controllers, but the mapping of the move controllers, the developers said on Discord, it's gonna be pretty much very similar to what they did in their first game, Apex Cybernetic. This is a game, a shooter that only utilizes move controllers, but also this shooter got a very nice melee as well. Some people like it, some people don't. I enjoyed it a lot, very nice little story, kind of like Doom VFR, but with proper like immersive controls. There was some graphical issues and stuff, and disappearing enemies straight away, but nevertheless a fun budget title. What I want to say is the system, what they've had built in for this game, worked pretty well. You have to get used to it for a bit, but worked very nice. You know, all the strafing, all the moving, very intuitive, and I'm assuming for fast-paced combat like Zero Calibre gonna be, it should work all right. 200 weapons work all right. Melee worked all right. So I think we pretty safe with the Zero Caliber when it releases eventually. And of course, when it comes to PlayStation VR, the game will release with multiplayer as well. It's gonna have co-op as on PC, but they're gonna do PvP with three different game modes. And also the game will support dedicated servers, so that's gonna be all right. But like I said, sadly we have to wait. Anyway, moving on to the next story and time to talk about PlayStation 5 a bit. Couple of months ago I spoke about the report from Bloomberg when they said Sony gonna do like a limited release and they just gonna manufacture not that many PS5s because they apparently couldn't do it. I said it probably won't happen and Sony probably gonna release normally so people be able to pre-order it with the usual shortages that happen every generation, but it's not gonna be limited release. And today we've got new report from Bloomberg and other sources and it just confirms from what I said, the limited release won't happen. Apparently Sony upped their production to 10 million units and that indicates that Sony is very confident in PlayStation 5 and of course Sony got all the data so they know what demand is. PlayStation 5 had a great announcement, people really liked it, the games, what they showed. The design split opinions, but nevertheless this design got people talking. The price and release date is not known, even though the rumors saying it's expected anytime soon, they're gonna announce it. Even Amazon pre-order page popped up, you cannot pre-order yet, but it looks like you'll be able very, very soon. So the price and release date should be known very soon as well. But also what is very encouraging, there shouldn't be too much shortages when you order on PS5, you should be able to get it. When it comes to PlayStation VR on PS5, of course, your current headset will work on it just fine. You unplug it from PS4 and plug it to PS5 and you're good to go. You can get yourself new camera. That's apparently gonna improve tracking a bit because it's got higher resolution. Something I'm interested in, but also what we do not know yet is about what PlayStation 5 VR games we're gonna get. From Sony at least they didn't officially announce anything, some developers announced it, like your Return to Nangrim that's gonna support ray tracing, there's some other games announced. But also I'm hearing Sony just kind of delayed some announcement because they want to do State of Play in August when they're gonna reveal a lot of games and that includes VR, so I'll be looking forward to it. Anyway, moving on to the next story and time to talk about Superhot VR once again. As you know, Mind Control Delete has released and this is coming without VR support. That was known because the game was in early access for a while. For full release, the developers kind of redesigned a lot of aspects of it, but it's flat game only. So what's happening with VR and what we can expect in the future? What the team saying is that they do play with VR, they do some cool stuff, but they cannot announce anything yet, but definitely when they're gonna have something cool to announce, they're gonna do it. It looks like they're working on VR, but kind of don't want to reveal anything. When it comes to Mind Control Delete, of course, designed as a flat game, it will probably never get VR. But when it comes to Superhot VR, this game actually outperformed the flat version, so the developers know it's very, very successful. And it still sells super good because it's always in the charts, in top 10. So what they doing, they saying they playing with VR, they've got a lot of awesome ideas, but they gonna only do another super hot when they can bring something big, something really, really cool to the game. And that's when they gonna reveal something. As of now, they just playing with it and see it, what they can do. I do hope we're gonna get some more Superhot VR because it's one of the biggest and one of the best performing and also one of the best playing PlayStation VR and virtual reality games in general. With such a original mechanics, it just plays so good. Very, very good successful story for this studio, so I do hope to see some more VR support in the future. Maybe brand new Superhot game, that would be awesome, but we just have to wait and see. Anyway, it's time now to talk about Classroom Aquatic again. Every couple of months I give you update about this game. This is a game that's been in the development since like, I don't know, 2016. If you YouTube it, there's an early demo being played by people. And sadly this game fully didn't come out yet. What's happened is they managed to raise the funds on Kickstarter. They've been working on the game. At one point they have to redesign all the engine because it was kind of broken, they said. Whatever they put new, they've been breaking something else. So they had to redesign all the game. The game main promise is you are like a scuba diver going to school to dolphins, trying to pass exams, cheating but not being caught. Very strange idea, very crazy game, looking like somebody who designed it, I don't know what they was thinking, but also it looks like it might be tons of fun. So what's happening with it now is the developers saying, yes, we are working on the final level of the game, and after we finish this final level, we're just gonna go through the game to squash all the bugs and all the imperfections, and then you should get it on your headset soon. So when it was announced, of course it was for PC VR and PlayStation VR. I wonder if those days they're gonna add the Quest version. Nevertheless, this is a game that is one of the longest developing games for virtual reality, I think. Taking the ages, but it looks like they just kind of having fun with it. Of course, because of Kickstarter, they kind of obliged to release it, even though, you know, with Kickstarter sometimes games not happening. But it looks like they finally, after all those years, what is it, like 5-6 years, finally they reaching the final stretch. So whoever, if any of you supported them on Kickstarter, or if any of you heard about this game in past, you finally be able to play it hopefully soon, like maybe this year even. That would be awesome. Okay, anyway, if you like what you're seeing, then please press a like, because it does helps the channel a lot. And if you're new to the channel and are not subscribed, then subscribe. It's always better when it's more of us. And that's it, bye.